Dear members of the Rockingham County School Community, I'm Oscar Scheichel, Superintendent for RCPS. We're now about halfway through the first semester of this difficult school year, and next week, we expect most of our students in elementary and middle school to return to in-person learning on an AB schedule. This COVID-19 pandemic has made the school year incredibly difficult for everyone. You know, teachers have been asked to reinvent school on short notice, to create learning environments that are completely different from a year ago, and to work with students in Zoom sessions where they are looking at a screen full of empty rectangles because students do not have their video on. When they began this process, they didn't know what could be reasonably expected to be accomplished in a day or in a week or a month. There were no milestones. And when we are making changes, it's important to know that we're not assigning blame to educators. It's about learning what we've experienced so far and to improve. At the same time, families have also struggled. They've struggled with schoolwork to the point where I'm getting emails from students' parents or grandparents, and they explain how students are learning, completing homework in tears because of all the work they have to do. You have to add to that the worries about health and safety, and now stress really becomes toxic for everyone. It's okay, and probably even absolutely necessary, that we spend time on relationships and community with our students, especially when they return to school in person. After all, that's what the first two letters in what we say RCPS stands for are, R and C, relationships and community. So we're going to slow down and we have to take a deep breath. Teachers deserve to have time to adjust their curriculum. Teachers deserve to set appropriate expectations. But students also deserve to have time to complete assignments that don't wear them out, and parents who already struggle with work and finding the time to help their students, they deserve time with their families that isn't full of schoolwork. So when we talk about showing that grace is greater than grades, we don't mean that we'll hand out grades for free or credits for free and that we don't have any expectations. We will not return to last spring where we weren't allowed to have accountability measures and require work to be done. We can adjust to how we look at grades, but we still expect that students are engaged in their learning environments. It's simply a matter of deciding what's really important. So between now and the end of the semester, students may be in class fewer than 20 times, and so teachers have to consider what it is in their classes that they really need their students to know or be able to do in order to be successful next year. When it comes to curriculum and expectations, teachers will have opportunities to narrow their curriculum, working together with other teachers, administrators, and content area supervisors. We have to understand that we need to reduce the amount of work if we want people to be able to focus and do well on the work they have. When it comes to grades, we can't eliminate expectations, but in order to adjust for these unique circumstances, we will split the semester basically into two portions. So one up to now, and then one from here on out for the rest of the semester. And we will provide different weights for that. So the first half of the semester will count for 40%. The second half will count for 60%. We will also set a floor of 40% for any assignment. And the reason is that the range for an F is really very, very broad, from 0 to 60%. What we are saying is that any student who's currently failing a class should be able to pass if they complete work for the rest of the semester that's at a C grade level work. And that seems fair. If you can do C level work for the second half of the semester, you should have a chance to pass. And in order for that to work, in terms of the math that's involved, 40% simply becomes the new zero. No grades lower than 40 will be assigned, but that allows a student with a C for the second half to actually pass the class. Now remember, a student who continues to not do any work or continues to work at a very low level will not benefit from that change. So a student may still fail a class. If a student fails a class, that class can be repeated. That's okay too. But we do have those expectations, but we need to see a reduction in work, and we are going to be gracious in how we assign these grades. At the elementary school level, we have also made a change to grading. Rather than continuing the use of letter grades, our teachers will provide descriptive evaluations of the work that students do and what students' needs are. This is actually something the Parent Advisory Committee and I talked about for almost an entire school year a few years back. And at the end of the year, the committee suggested that we move forward with this approach. And now is a good time to take a look at how that will work. Now, none of these changes that we're implementing for this school year are considered permanent. We will have conversations about this with parents, with educators. We will review all of it and then decide what, if any, changes should become part of regular policy. In the meantime, I want to thank everyone who's helped us make this school year successful, even if it is so different. The school board, our CPS staff, and our families for reaching out to let me know about your concerns and for being flexible in order to provide meaningful education during this unique time. I also want to remind you that our best chance to have more students in school in person is to keep infection rates low. Masks are mandatory in school, and I ask that you also follow the guidelines from infectious disease experts when you're not at school. Masks do work, as does physical distancing. We won't have to wear the masks forever, but while we face this contagious virus that we don't yet have a vaccine for, these are our best options to be able to learn in classrooms. Again, thanks for everyone's efforts, and I hope to see you soon in one of our schools. Please stay safe and healthy.